In this video, we'll cover the structure of a prokaryotic cell and see how prokaryotic cells differ from eukaryotic cells. Have you ever wondered about early primitive forms of life? Or wondered what they would have looked like if we traveled back in time to see them? How would they be different from modern-day, more evolved cells? Well, there's no need for time travel, because in fact, most of them still exist today. The primitive cells with no defined nucleus or membrane-bound organelles are called prokaryotes. The term prokaryote is derived from the Greek language. Pro means before, and karyon means nucleus. Prokaryotes were around before the evolution of cells containing a nucleus. Prokaryotes are primarily unicellular organisms and come in various shapes and sizes, like coccus, bacillus, vibrio, spiral, and stalked. Examples of prokaryotes include bacteria, blue-green algae, and mycoplasma, also known as pleuropneumonia-like organisms or PPLOs. Here's a typical prokaryotic cell. Let me give you a tour. First, we'll look at the outer membranes and associated structures, then the structures outside the membranes, and finally, we'll introduce the structures inside the cell membranes. Surrounding many prokaryotic cells outside the cell wall is a sticky, slimy coating called the glycocalyx. Some others, known as capsulated prokaryotes, are surrounded by a thick, hard capsule. Underneath lies the cell wall, a rigid structure made of peptidoglycan or murine, and it gives the cell its shape. Next, there's the cytoplasmic membrane, made up of lipids and proteins. Its fundamental building block is the phospholipid. The phospholipids in the membrane arrange themselves into a phospholipid bilayer. Moving on to structures outside the membranes, we have flagella and pilus. Flagella are microscopic structures, similar to hair. Made from the protein flagellin, they help bacteria to get around. Pili are appendages that help prokaryotes attach to other cells and colonize them. Now, peering inside the membrane, we see other structures. Jelly-like cytoplasm fills the cell. It's mainly composed of water, but also contains enzymes, nutrients, ions, waste gases, and several low molecular weight compounds. In the nuclear and cytoplasmic regions of the cell, we can see inclusion bodies, granular aggregates of proteins with no membrane. The nucleoid is the region of the cell that contains most of the DNA. By weight, it's around 80% DNA, 10% protein, and 10% RNA. Elsewhere in the cell, there are also smaller circular pieces of DNA called plasmids. Make sure you don't confuse prokaryotes with eukaryotes. A main point of difference is that prokaryotes lack a well-defined nucleus and membrane-bound organelles. Prokaryotes are generally smaller and multiply faster too. Today we studied the various structural features of a prokaryotic cell and considered the differences between eukaryotic cells and prokaryotic cells. Thanks for watching.